How well do you really know the accounting equation? Let's put it to the test. My name's James, you're watching Accounting Stuff, and today I've prepared 20 multiple choice questions for you. They start easy, but each one gets a little bit tougher. So grab a pen, play along, and remember to drop your score in the comments when you finish. Let's see if you can get them all right. Question one, what is the basic accounting equation? Is it assets plus equity equal liabilities? Assets equal equity minus liabilities, assets equal liabilities plus equity, or liabilities equal assets plus equity? The answer is C, assets equal liabilities plus equity. This formula is the foundation of the double entry accounting system. Question two, if assets do not equal liabilities plus equity, what does this indicate? That there's an error in the accounting records, that the business is making a loss, that the business has negative equity, or that the accounting equation doesn't apply to this business. And the answer is A, the accounting equation always has to balance. So if assets don't equal liabilities plus equity, then something has been recorded incorrectly. Question three, which of the following is classified as an asset? Is it accrued expenses, loans payable, retained earnings, or inventory? And the answer is D. Inventory is an asset because it's a resource that a business owns that it expects to sell in the future for economic benefit. Question four, which of the following is classified as a liability? Is it accounts receivable, accounts payable, share capital, or equipment? The answer is B. Accounts payable is a liability because it represents money that a business owes to suppliers. This means it has an obligation to pay them in the future. Question five, which of the following is included in equity? Interest payable, prepaid expenses, retained earnings, or cash? It's C, retained earnings represent accumulated profits kept in the business. By the way, if this quiz is getting tricky, don't worry. I've made a free accounting equation cheat sheet, which you can grab as a handy study guide. I'll leave a link to it down in the description. Question six, which financial statement reflects the accounting equation at a point in time? Could it be the income statement, the cash flow statement, the statement of owner's equity, or the balance sheet? The answer is D. The balance sheet is structured directly on the accounting equation. It gives a snapshot of a business's assets, liabilities, and equity at a specific point in time. Question 7. A business has $20,000 in liabilities and $50,000 in equity. What are its assets? Are they $70,000, $30,000, $20,000, or $10,000? And the answer is A. According to the accounting equation, assets equal liabilities plus equity. If we add $20,000 in liabilities to $50,000 in equity, then we get $70,000 in assets. Question 8. A business has $50,000 in assets and $20,000 in liabilities. What is its equity? Is it $70,000, $30,000, $20,000, or $10,000? It's B. If we rearrange the accounting equation, then we get equity is equal to assets minus liabilities or net assets. $50,000 in assets minus $20,000 in liabilities is $30,000 in equity. Question 9. The income statement is linked to the accounting equation through assets, liabilities, equity, or dividends. The answer is C. The income statement shows a business's revenues and expenses, which are used to calculate net profit. Net profit increases retained earnings, which is a component of equity. Question 10. Which of the following is not classified as a liability? Prepaid expenses, accounts payable, a bank loan, or unearned revenue? It's A. Prepaid expenses are in fact a type of asset. They represent payments made in advance for goods or services to be received in the future. Question 11. Which of the following is not classified as an asset? Accounts receivable, inventory, equipment, or accounts payable? The answer is D. Accounts payable is a type of liability. It represents what a business owes to its suppliers. Question 12. Which of the following is not included in equity? Could it be share capital, accrued revenue, retained earnings, or common stock? The answer is B. Accrued revenue or unbilled revenue is an asset. It represents income that has been earned but not yet received or recorded. Question 13. An owner contributes cash into their business. How does this affect the accounting equation? Assets increase and equity increases. Assets increase and liabilities increase. Assets decrease and equity decreases. Or assets increase and liabilities decrease. A. The business's cash goes up, so its assets increase, and its equity increases because the owner's claim on the business has grown. Question 14. An owner withdraws cash from their business for personal use. How does this affect the accounting equation? Assets increase and equity increases. Assets decrease and liabilities increase. Assets decrease and equity decreases. Or assets increase and liabilities decrease. It's C. When the owner takes out cash, their assets decrease, and equity decreases because the owner's claim on the business's net assets is reduced. Question 15. A business issues a $1,500 cash payment to settle an account payable. How does this affect the accounting equation? Assets increase and liabilities increase. Assets decrease and equity decreases. Assets decrease and liabilities increase. Or assets decrease and liabilities decrease. And the answer is D. Paying off an account payable reduces cash, which is an asset, by $1,500. It also reduces the outstanding liability by $1,500. Question 16. A business buys equipment worth $3,000 on account. How does this affect the accounting equation? Assets increase and equity increases. Assets increase and liabilities increase. Assets decrease and liabilities decrease. Or assets increase and liabilities decrease. The answer is B. The business acquires equipment worth $3,000, so fixed assets go up. And since the purchase was made on account, a new account payable of $3,000 is created, which is, of course, a liability. Question 17. Which of the following transactions would increase total equity? A business earns $5,000 in revenue. A business pays out $1,000 in expenses. An owner withdraws $2,000 cash for personal use, or the business borrows $3,000 from a bank. The answer is A. Revenue increases net profit, and net profit, as you know, flows into retained earnings, which is part of equity. Question 18. A business has total assets of $80,000 and total liabilities of $110,000. What is its total equity? Is it $30,000, $110,000, minus $30,000, or $190,000? The answer is C. We know that equity is equal to net assets. If we take $80,000 in assets and minus $110,000 in liabilities, then we get $30,000 in negative equity. This means the business owes more to external parties than it owns, which is a financially risky position to be in. Question 19. Which of the following sets of figures does not balance under the accounting equation? $80,000 in assets, $30,000 in liabilities, and $50,000 in equity. $50,000 in assets, $20,000 in liabilities, and $25,000 in equity. $90,000 in assets, $40,000 in liabilities, and $50,000 in equity. Or $120,000 in assets, $70,000 in liabilities, and $50,000 in equity. The answer is B. $20,000 in liabilities plus $25,000 in equity is $40,000. This doesn't match the $50,000 in assets. Question 20. Listen carefully to this one. A business sells goods for $1,000 cash that originally cost $700. How does this affect the accounting equation? Assets increase by $1,000 and equity increases by $1,000. Assets increase by $300 and equity increases by $300. Assets increase by $700 and equity increases by $700. All assets increase by $300 and equity increases by $300. And the answer is D. The sale increases cash by $1,000, but at the same time, it reduces inventory by $700. The net effect is a $300 increase in assets. This $300 of profit flows through retained earnings, which increases equity. Bonus question. Which of the following is a component of the expanded accounting equation? Inventory, accounts payable, dividends, or notes receivable? The answer is C. In the expanded accounting equation, equity is broken down into its components, which includes things like capital contributions, revenue, expenses, and of course, dividends. If you enjoyed this little quiz, give the video a thumbs up and drop your score down in the comments. I'd love to see how you did. Don't worry if you didn't score 20 out of 20 on the first try. Accounting takes practice, so take a beat and try again. For extra help, you can always grab my free accounting equation cheat sheet or check out my tutorials on the accounting equation and the expanded accounting equation. See you soon.